Welcome, folks. Thanks for tuning in to 2K Sports for the latest presentation of our NBA basketball. Along with Steve Kerr, Clark Kellogg, and our sideline reporter, Doris Burke, this is Kevin Harlan. We have an interconference showdown here in Boston where the Celtics will square off. All fueled up and ready to go. Brought to you by Gatorade. Let's check out who's on the floor. So on the floor for Houston, Beverly and Harden man the backcourt. Terrence Jones is down low with Howard. And it's Ariza in at the three.
Terrence Jones is a great fit in this up-tempo style the Rockets like to play. A fluid athlete. He's able to outrun and outquick most of the power forwards he goes up against.
And here's Houston. Beverly the pass to Ariza. Beverly with the ball. Now guarded by Bradley. Jones, no luck.
Boy, the effort was there, but he just couldn't quite fight his way through traffic.
Sullinger with a screen for Rondo. And the call is going to be... Yes, yes, it is. An illegal screen.
Well, an illegal screen is one of the toughest calls for the official to make.
You know, I agree with you. You've got to have some sympathy for the referees when they have to make calls like that, but they get paid well, and they're the best in the business, so they can handle it.
Doris Burke has an update for us. Doris?
I was able to talk with Brad Stevens for a minute. A lot of his strategy is focused on Dwight Howard, and rightly so. He said, we know Dwight can do it all, and it is going to take a five-man effort to slow him down. He can finish, block shots, rebound. The guy is almost 7 feet of pure muscle, and there is just no way to handle him one-on-one. If there is a way, the NBA hasn't discovered it yet.
And as always, Doris, thank you. Here's Rondo. James Harden picking up that last basket. Outside Rondo. In the corner, Bradley with it. Shot clock at six. Bass with a screen for breath. And there's the defensive 3 second call. Say are really to be commended, Clark, for rebuilding this team without tearing it down to the studs or tanking, if you will.
Yeah, absolutely, Kevin. I mean, they've improved dramatically with Harden and Howard, but this is a team that's held a winning record in the West now for 8 straight seasons. Mm. That's pretty impressive.
It is. And the technical free throw is good.
And the Rockets showed great patience and planning over time, freeing up cap space, acquiring young assets. That enabled them to trade for James Harden and, of course, attract Dwight Howard in free agency, too.
Now here's Sullinger. The feed now to Bass. Fires from 14 and a foul on the shot. He'll go to the stripe for two.
And this Rockets team, for all of its success, is still young. Still developing that chemistry, but make no mistake, they've elevated themselves from playoff contender to potential title contender. I think exciting times are certainly in store in Houston.
The free throw drops for Bass.
Brandon Bass now in his 10th season out of LSU, pick and pop, power forward. That mid-range shot is a strength of his game, and he's really improved defensively the last couple of years as well.
And so Bass nails both of them.
And Bass is much more of an offensive-minded big man. At 6'8", he's not a big-time defender or rebounder. His job really is to space the floor and put points on the board.
Rondo kicks to Bradley. Green dishes to Bradley. Stolen by Beverly. In low to Howard. Well-timed pass, and he goes straight to the bucket for the layup.
Patrick Beverly.
And Brandon Bass earning the nickname No Pass Bass. This is team more career turnovers than assists.
Yeah, but that's his role, Kevin. You know, when he's open, knock it down. And what I like about Bass is that he has improved his defense considerably. The last couple of years with Doc Rivers in Boston, that was something that Doc really emphasized.
Bradley can't get it to go.
That's 3 misses to start the game, guys. Does not bode well here early.
Harden kicks to Jones. Back to Harden. Ariza passes to Howard. That's good.
4 or 5 shots have dropped for them already. Not a bad way to get things started.
Celtics trail by five. Guys are looking for a spark here.
Yeah, I mean, a cold stretch.
Here's Green. Yeah, that one's good.
Yeah, no mistakes on the offensive execution there.
And we're approaching about 3.5 minutes played in the first quarter. Jones with the screen on Rondo. Harden with it. He's picked up by Rondo. Beverly dishes to Ariza. Now the pass to Jones. And he drops in the layup off the glass. Jones has got his second bucket of the night.
They are really doing a nice job establishing a presence inside early.
And that's going to open things up for them on the perimeter going forward, Clark.
Back to Rondo. Pass with a screen for Rondo. Six on the shot clock. It's Bradley on the wing. Good. And it's Rondo who picks up the assist.
The easiest way to do it sometimes is with the bounce pass.
Houston leading by three. Dishes to Howard. Feeds to Beverly. From the arc. They get it back. Here's Jones. Lays it up and banks it in. Jones has got his third basket of the night.
There it is again. On a lot of their possessions this first half, they've established great position inside.
Yeah, getting the ball into the post should be their first option every time down. Force the defense to adapt and adjust.
And Beverly kicks to Harden. And that one's good.
Boy, they've settled into their offense very quickly here today.
Yeah, they're zoned in, making the most out of their possessions here.
And guys, let's get your take on the scoring breakdown so far for the Rockets.
You know, guys, we've really seen them do a lot of damage in the paint so far.
And the other thing they're doing is forcing a lot of turnovers, and that's helping them to get easy points at the other end.
James Harden with those rush hour handles, whether it's breaking his man down in isolation or running the pick and roll, he keeps that thing on a string.
Now, here's Bradley. Clock at six. Here's Bass, rejected by Jones. That'll be Boston as it goes out of bounds. Celtics retain possession.
2 seconds on the shot clock, two.
Here's Sullinger. He's had some playing time, but no scoring yet from him. And Harden, a left-hander. Defenders tend to have more trouble, it seems, guys, with softballs.
Well, and especially with Harden because of how crafty he is. He's got that Manu Ginobili Euro move. I mean, that's what separates him. He draws contact and seems to just go right through players.
And foul called as he misses. He'll go to the line and shoot two. Jeff Green picks one up.
Well, James Harden is a pure scorer, but for him to get this Rockets team where they hope to go, I think he has to lead in more ways than just offensively. Really needs to set the example with his defense, his effort, and his unselfishness as well.
Two shots.
And Harden is a great passer, but last season at times it seemed like he settled into being a ball stopper. He's so talented, so gifted offensively. He's an excellent offensive player when he's isolated, but this team has so much offensive talent, I think they're best served to keep that ball hopping. And that goes for any team, but clearly a team that has the weapons that Houston does.
And both free throws good for James Harden. And you think of the superstar two guards who have won titles over the years, whether it's Kobe Bryant in Los Angeles or Dwayne Wade in Miami, Steve, they've all gotten after it defensively.
Yeah, and I think that's where Harden has to take the next step, in my opinion. When he's locked in, he's great. You know, he's got the long wingspan. He's got the strength. It's just about having that focus and that that energy, that intensity that you need at the defensive end.
Now, here is Harden. After Jared Sullinger's miss, here's Beverly. Blocked. And they'll keep possession. Ariza outside. Back to Jones. Fades and shoots. Another miss by Houston.
The defense better not make a habit of giving him that shot. I mean, he doesn't miss many of them.
Guys, they're looking for a spark here.
Yeah, I mean, a cold stretch offensively. They desperately need a basket.
Bradley passes to Green. Shot clock at six. Left side Rondo. Tried to bank it in, but he misses.
Really good work defensively. This coach has to be happy with his team.
Yeah, forcing that miss right there, great effort.
Ariza against Bradley. Howard setting the pick for Harden. A chance there to push it to double digits, but it's off the mark. Outside Rondo. Pass to Bass. Celtics passing it around. Sellinger dishes to Green. Looking to end the drought. Basket is good, the assist so far.
There's a chance he could have a big game if they don't D him up more tightly on the perimeter.
And now the first timeout called here for the Rockets.
Well, kind of an interesting paradox for Jeff Green. He's much better offensively playing at the power forward spot as a spread four, but defensively he's much better guarding threes.
And a new group in for the Celtics. Kelly Olynyk's checked in for Jared Sullinger. Wallace comes in for Brandon Bass. Evan Turner, he's checked in for Green. And Smart subbed in for Avery Bradley. Houston leading by six. And Jeff Green, not a big rebounder, struggles guarding in the low block. What do you think, Clark, is his best position?
You know, it's hard for me to say, Kevin. I think he's probably just a 3/4. I think at the four he has a little bit more of a quickness advantage. So I would probably look to playing him at that position.
Now here's Turner. Harden missing his last shot. Hit his leg. And the ref's whistling a kick ball. Houston making some changes. Jeff Adrian's checked in for Jones, for James Harden. And it's Cannon in for Patrick Beverley. Rockets on defense. 6-point game. And Turner kicks to Wallace. Back to Turner. Smart passes to Rondo. Clock at six.
Well, Rajon Rondo still in a Celtics uniform, and that didn't seem like a foregone conclusion over the last season. Boston in the midst of a complete rebuild, and Rondo already in the prime of his career, so a lot of discussion about a possible trade.
You know, you look at Rondo and you get the sense that perhaps he covets a chance to lead the Celtics as the team's undisputed franchise player. You know, that's a mantle he's not quite carried in his career. He said he'd love to have another 10 years in Boston.
That one is no good. And for the Celtics, hard to give up an elite player like Rondo.
Well, Brad Stevens called him their clear-cut best player and the leader of this team. And, you know, Rondo has a chance to put himself in that echelon if he sticks around Boston in terms of being one of the all-time great Celtics.
Now, Smart. Trevor Ariza missing from long range. And it's sent back by Howard. And that's out of bounds. Boston will retain possession. Marcus Thornton, he's checked in for Rajon Rondo. Here's Smart. Kicks it to Thornton. Five on the clock. Here's Olynyk. Here's Smart. Boston again missing. Rockets leading by five. Ariza outside. Here's Kanan. Still getting warmed up offensively. No buckets yet in the game for him. Ariza goes in. Wing shot on the way. Here's Howard. And he was fouled in the act of shooting. Chance here now for a three-point play.
They've been strong here in the early going, Kevin. Very effective from inside.
The Rockets shooting their fourth shot at the foul line here. Like you were saying, going strong inside, building a strong lead here in the first.
And the confidence factor is a big part of that, Kevin. Taking that ball inside, you get high-quality shots, you get conversions, you keep pressure on the defense, and it just continues to build on itself.
Now here's Turner, and he gets it to go. Here's Kanan. 6-point game. Screen by Howard. Cannon dishes to Ariza. Here's Kanan. just four to shoot. Houston needs to get a shot off.
Daniel.
Off target from three-point range.
That was a good rebound right there, but they haven't been very strong on the glass so far.
Well, they've got to meet the energy that they're facing right now. So important to battle on the boards.
Now here's Smart. He hasn't yet put up any points in this one. Outside Turner. There's the triple. And the shot is good. Now it's just a three-point Houston lead.
You know what, guys? He can really light it up from the perimeter at times.
Now a timeout called by Houston. A minute 50 left to play here in the first. Here's Kanan. There's the dish to Daniels. He feeds it to Kanan. Pass to Ariza. Here's Kanan. Five to shoot. The Rockets with another miss. Celtics trail by three. Passes it to Smart. 1:14 left in the first quarter. And Olenek kicks to Smart. And it's Turner off the drive. And it's blocked. Now here's Ariza. No scoring yet from him, but that's likely to change.
You know, 9 times out of 10, he's going to knock that one down. He'll spray that one on you.
Smart passes to Wallace. There's 45 seconds left to play in the first quarter. Smart puts the pick in for Thornton. Here's Turner. Nice shot from the wing. Turner's got 7 points in the game. Houston's gone 0-4 from three-point land to start out, looking cold from outside. 23 seconds left in the first quarter. Kanan kicks to Ariza. They need this one, and it's going to be 2 free throws. Drew contact on the shot.
Nice work to get inside and draw the foul.
Yeah, it's obvious. The defense not going to allow many easy layups. They're going to make you earn it from the line.
The Rockets have gone 3 of 4 at the free throw line tonight.
Well, this is an area of concern for this club. They only shot 71% from the line last year.
And those aren't the kind of numbers they can afford to repeat throughout this season.
First free throw is good. And that one goes in. 2 from the line that time. Celtics trail by 3. Olenek sets a screen for Smart. He dishes it to Olenek. And still a close game as the first quarter comes to a close. Rockets lead by 3. And back in a moment as we'll get underway with quarter number 2.
I'm a gangster, but y'all leading.
Neither team able to build much of a lead up to this point as we start the second quarter. And looking at what we've seen from Houston, what do you guys think?
And how about the defense, guys? They have really controlled the lane with their shot blocking.
Yeah, excellent defense there. Every shot has either been altered or rejected.
So bring your friends over, y'all come inside. We got a world premiere right here, not getting lost. So don't change the diesel, turn it up a little. I got a living room full of fine dime bristles. Waiting on the bristle, the dizzle, and the shizzle. G's to the biz act, now ladies, see we listen. When the crib, my- mama. Drop it like it's hot. Drop it like it's hot. Drop it like it's hot. When the pigs try to get at you. Park it like it's hot. Park it like it's hot. Park it like it's hot. Never get an attitude. Pop it like it's hot. Pop it like it's hot. Pop it like it's hot. I got the rollie on my arm and I'm pouring. And I'm over best because I got it going on. I'm a bad boy with a lot of drop my own cars and wear my own clothes. Snoop Dogg, yeah, he's so sharp. On the TV screen and in the magazines. If you pay me close, you want a red bean. Oh, you got it, so you want to pop back.
Celtics trail by three. This is how the floor looks for the Rockets starting the second. Jones is out there with Jeff Adrian. Then it's Harden. Then it's Patrick Beverley. And it's Daniels in at the two-guard spot.
Rajon Rondo, one of the NBA's elite playmakers. He's led the league in assists per game twice in the last three seasons. Great at keeping his dribble alive and forcing the defense to react.
Now, here's Beverley looking for his first basket still in this one. Harden, that's good.
Boy, that was a rugged screen set there, fellas, and the defense didn't even try to go through that one.
Young outside. He kicks to Rondo. It's rebounded by Houston. Adrian's got three rebounds so far in the game. And let's now go to the sideline. We'll catch up here with Doris Burke. Doris?
Well, Kevin, Jared Solinger has developed some very thick skin during his time in the league. Solinger said, because I had Satch Solinger as a coach. So I learned early saying, I was blessed to have an angry coach. It's very hard to get into Jared's head, guys.
It is indeed. Thank you, Doris. Here is Harden after Jeff Green's bucket. Jones with it, and Young picks him up defensively. Rondo with the steal. The feed to Solinger. We're closing in on 2 minutes played here in the second quarter. Rondo kicks to Solinger. It's good, coming on the assist by Rajon Rondo. Rondo's got four assists now tonight.
They've had assists now on their last three baskets.
And it's not just their passing, but their cutting, their movement together as a unit that's led to that.
Now here's Jones. 6 points for him. And here's Beverley. Shot clock at six. And it goes as the official calls the foul. Count it. He'll shoot one more at the free throw line.
Really aggressive play, taking it to the rim against the big man.
Tell you what, I love that fearless attitude.
The Rockets making a switch here. Johnson's checked in. The Rockets shooting their seventh free throw attempt here. That's good from Beverley.
Well, the Celtics certainly played with a lot of passion last year. They got off to a start that few thought they would achieve, but even playing with passion can't cover up the holes in the roster.
And it's Green missing. Houston in the lead, and it's the Rockets on the break. Here's Johnson, and he was fouled on the way up. Two free throws now for him. That's his first personal foul. I got to give the Celtics credit, though. They were never really in contention for anything last year, but Clark, they played their heart.
Yeah, they did play hard, played with energy. And that goes a long way to trying to build a foundation of being successful going forward. It might not have done much for them last year, but that attitude is something they can build on.
And he sinks the second. As you might have expected them to be, Clark, the Rockets were very good on the road.
Well, with the way that team was comprised with multiple threats on the floor offensively, it's no surprise to see them excel on the road.
Now, here is Young. Back to Rondo. There's the pass to Green. Boston, no good that time either.
Not able to find it here in the second. He's off stride and off track just a bit after that one he had earlier.
Outside, Rondo feeds it to Bass. Outside, Rondo. shoots a three. They shoot again. And it's going to be two free throws. Drew contact on the shot.
Yeah, the referee's all over that one.
No doubt about it. Clearly a foul. Nothing to argue about there.
Well, as you said, the Rockets strong on the road last year. 21-20 record. And anytime you're over 500 on the away side, you're in a good spot.
The free throw drops for Bass.
What's really scary about the Rockets is that they let some games slip away last year on the road and still managed to win 21 games away from home. So I would expect that mark to improve this season.
Avery Bradley, he's checked in for Young. And so Bass nails both of them.
You know, a lot of people thought and assumed that when the Celtics traded Pearson KG, they just took salary in return. But, you know, the guys they got proved to be valuable mentors for the youngsters on that team.
Adrian down low. Bass is there. Adrian can't hit. Rondo with it. And just over 3.5 minutes played here in the second quarter. And he gets it to go. And that's now 11 points for Jeff Green. And when you trade away stars, guys, and start a rebuilding process, it can't be understated enough that you need to have a few vets to help the process.
Yeah, I think you look at how some players played last year and, you know, their games grew. Definitely helped to have a vet or two around just to kind of help the development process.
Jones, no luck.
That's an easy shot there. That's a shot that he should make more often than not.
Rondo kicks to Bass. Dishes it to Sullinger. Takes the 12-footer and hits. Now it's a three-point Celtic lead. For Houston, they've gone 2 of 5 from the field here in the second quarter, shooting 40%. Green against Harden. Adrian dishes to Johnson. Pass to Jones. 6 on the shot clock. It's stolen by Bass. Rondo against Johnson. Here's Bass. Basket is good. The assist from Rondo. Rondo's got 6 assists now in the game. Rockets trail by 5. Beverly, the pass to Jones. Kicks it to Beverly. Green against Harden. To the paint. Here's Adrian. And he gets it to go. Adrian's got his first bucket of the night. Now Rondo. There's the dish to Sullinger. Poked away.
Tough D on the inside.
Put up a roadblock, a construction barrel right there. That's what he brings defensively.
Johnson comes up empty down low.
Well defended, and he's not someone who responds well to that kind of defensive pressure.
Rondo kicks to Sullinger. Fades away. That drops. Sullinger's got the lead up to 5 now for the Celtics.
It was a slow start for him, but he started to take off since we hit the second quarter, guys.
Now, here's Beverly. He's covered by Rondo. Beverly dishes to Adrian. He feeds it to Beverly. Houston moving the ball around. Just 3 to shoot. Harden can't hit.
When he's wide open like that, he'll rarely miss those.
Rondo passes to Bass. And so he earns a trip to the line. Official saw the contact, and he'll shoot 2.
That's his second.
This will make 4 trips to the line so far in the game.
So far, the job he's done getting to the line and knocking down his free throws has been superb.
Well, it's a great way to cash in on some easy points, and he understands that, and he shoots the ball with great confidence from there.
And guys, the numbers don't lie. I mean, he was such a reliable presence at the free throw line all throughout last season.
Kelly Olynyk checked in for the Celtics.
Okay.
Well, going into last season, the Celtics had made 6 straight playoff appearances, 2 trips to the finals, and 1 NBA championship. But there was no question, last year was the beginning of a rebuild.
Harden gets the bucket. So the Celtics called timeout, their first. Boston making a switch here. Wallace is checked in, and a change for the Rockets. Howard's checked in. Boston leading by 5. Outside Rondo. Pass to Olynyk. And it's good, coming on the assist by Rajon Rondo.
It seems that every pass they make is leading to a score here. I mean, that's just exquisite ball movement.
Yeah, they're making the right play, they're working together, and they're just looking for the best shot they can every possession.
Now here's Howard. 7 points in the game. There's the bucket. Good. Howard's got 9. Here's Boston now. They're on a 14-6 run. Olynyk sets a screen for Rondo. Passes it to Olynyk. Bradley up top. He's guarded by Johnson. 4 on the clock. Green, no luck.
Rebounds are split just about down the middle in this game, Clark.
I'd venture to guess whichever team is able to maintain that energy level on the glass will have the upper hand the rest of the way.
Now, here is Harden. He's got 10. Howard kicks to Harden. Harden left side. Celtics leading by 5. Outside Rondo. Left side Rondo. And that one's on target from the wing. And the Celtics lead by 7. Here's Beverly. He dishes it to Jones. Howard in the post. He's against Olynyk, and the shot is good. And 11 points for Howard.
Nice soft touch to drop that one in.
Boston's gone 0-2 from deep here in the second. Now here's Rondo. He's covered closely. To the middle. Here's Bradley. And you can count it. He'll go to the line with a chance to make it 3.
And they've set up countless buckets off assists. That's a huge part of what they've been doing here today. A
lot of dime dropping going on out there, Steve.
Evan Turner. He's checked in for Boston. Smart comes in for Rajon Rondo. Trevor Ariza's checked in for the Rockets. Cannon comes in for Patrick Beverley.
Shooting 100% in the quarter. They've made them all, taking full advantage at the line.
Well, it's a nice job of really making the most of their opportunities. He has not been on his game, and, you know, their deficit isn't totally on him, but he has not helped the situation.
And Turner kicks to Smart. From deep. Shot is off. Rockets trail by 8. Outside, Jones. The feed now to Cannon. It's Ariza on the wing. Shoots from the baseline. That's good.
The entire defense was frozen footed. Nobody picked up the shooter, Kevin.
Here's Smart. He hasn't scored yet. That I'm sure will change. Olynyk dishes to Smart. No one near Turner as he lets it go. Second shot opportunity, and he was fouled on the way up. 2 free throws now for him.
Easy call there.
No question about that one. You could hear the impact from where I am.
And let's quickly check out the scoring breakdown here for the Celtics.
And they're doing a fantastic job of finding the open man and getting easy looks.
Well, the job of penetrating that they've done so far has really been excellent. I mean, they've done a nice job driving to the hoop effectively. Kelly Olynyk out of Gonzaga was a point guard for the majority of his high school career before a growth spurt shot him up to 7 feet tall. You can see the result of playing point guard for so long. He's a big man with shooting and ball handling skills of a much smaller player.
And so Olynyk nails both of them.
And Olynyk, growing up in a basketball family, his father a coach at the collegiate level, also coached his own kids, his mother a longtime referee. So Kelly's instincts and understanding of the game certainly have benefited from that wealth of knowledge growing up.
From the sideline, let's catch up with Doris Burke.
Hi, Kevin. When former college coach Brad Stevens came in to coach the Boston Celtics, some worried that he'd have a tough time winning over headstrong point guard Rajon Rondo. But the two hit it off. Rondo said they become best friends, adding, "We talk every day. We laugh and joke. He has my full support. I'm behind him 100%. Kevin?
Rondo keeping an open mind and making himself accountable to Stevens' vision, Doris. Thanks. And Olynyk in his final season at Gonzaga, leading Division I basketball Clark and player efficiency rating.
Well, we know the analytics guys are going to love this, but he shot 63% from the field, Kevin, even shooting a number of shots from the perimeter. And a survey of NBA GMs ranked him the top steal of the draft. And I wouldn't disagree with that. I mean, he's a big guy that's mobile, skilled, with tremendous upside.
The Celtics with the lead. Now here's Smart. He hasn't yet put up any points in this one. Looking for Wallace. He gets it there. Smart kicks to Turner. Shot clock at 6. Here's Thornton. And so he earns a trip to the line. Officials saw the contact and he'll shoot 2.
Well, after 3.5 seasons in Sacramento, Marcus Thornton was traded to the Nets last year, and he rallied back from what had been his worst season in the NBA. He shot much better in Brooklyn. It seemed to be a good fit playing with that playoff team.
Free throw drops for Thornton. And Thornton from Baton Rouge played collegiately at LSU.
Some have called him the Bayou Bomber. I like that name because he can fill it up in a hurry, and scoring is certainly what he does best.
And the Rockets making a change here. Adrian's checked in. He hits both from the stripe.
Well, you know, not everybody was happy with Dwight Howard signing in Houston. The Rockets starting center, Amir Ashik, was not shy about expressing his displeasure. And, you know, I think that hung over the team for a while. And it wasn't until late in the season that that was kind of put to rest.
And early on last season, the Rockets tried starting Dwight Howard and Ashik together. But it didn't last you.
Well, it worked defensively, Kevin, but on offense, there just wasn't enough floor spacing. So from that point on, Kevin McHale would only use that combination against certain matchups. But for the most part, he went with a smaller format.
He hits the second from the line.
The Rockets, to me, are an emerging factor in the West. Not 100% sold on them being championship caliber, but I still think you've got to give that front office a lot of credit in terms of what they got out of the superstar tandem of Harden and Howard. I think it's a strong foundation of scoring and defense.
Shot clock is off. This should be the last possession of the quarter.
That's what they should have in mind here.
Here's Kanan. 5 points in the game. Here's Howard, goes to the fadeaway and cans it. Howard's got 6 points in the quarter. 5 seconds left in the first half of basketball. Thornton for 3. He got it up that time, but it wouldn't fall for him. Second quarter ends in a tight one. Celtics out in front, up 4. And a chance now to send you over to Doris Burke, standing by on the sideline. Doris?
Yes, Kevin, I'm here with Dwight Howard. And, Dwight, you look really strong so far tonight. What's been your approach?
I'm just trying to play with a lot of energy. I do the best I can on the defensive end to help my teammates out. Post hard.
Dwight, thank you so much. Kevin, one of the most intimidating defenders in the league.
Thank you, Doris. And we'll be back after halftime for the start of the second half.